Little Drops of Wonderful podcast. My name is Ali and this is my channel to talk about all things crochet, knitting and craft related. This is about the 10th time I have started this particular podcast. I'm not having a good time of it. I can't seem to get the words out. I've also changed my top twice because it was making me feel uncomfortable as I'm sitting on the floor and it kept wrinkling. Anyway, you can find me on Ravelry and Instagram as Starry Eyes Ali, and this is episode 15. Welcome to you all. We are now at over 500 subscribers. I haven't checked it in a couple of days. So welcome to all new people and thank you so much for choosing to subscribe. If anyone has come here from a recommendation from anyone, like on another podcast or on Instagram or anything like that, do let me know, because I'd really be interested, in case I haven't seen it myself, to wander over and discover new people. And yeah, that'd be really handy if you could let me know. It's been a little bit longer than intended since I last did a sort of full podcast because I have been busy celebrating my 40th birthday, which if you are a regular viewer of my podcast, you will know that I have been gearing up to turning 40 because I haven't stopped harping on about it. But anyway, I turned 40 on Wednesday, today's Sunday. So I am now 40 and 4 days and it has been quite a week of celebrating. And last night was our family meal for my 40th, which was really, really lovely. There was 11 of us went to a local restaurant and there was lots of Prosecco and fun and cake and food. And it was a really good night, but I think everyone's kind of feeling the effects of it today. So everyone's downstairs at the moment, nursing cups of tea and watching the telly and just generally having a very chilled out day. And that is why I am in a slightly different location. I am in my eldest daughter's bedroom, which is actually in the loft. So I've got plenty of light up here. I've got a very big skylight thing above me. Oh, does that change when I waggle about? Anyway, I've also got a different phone because, yeah, things seem to be conspiring against me for this podcast today. I'm using my husband's phone to film this because I dropped my own phone down the toilet last night. Yeah. So, into a clean toilet, I hasten to add. It was our home toilet and no one had used it when I dropped the phone in it. Excuse me, still got a cough. So it's drying out in a bag of rice downstairs. My husband very kindly lent me his phone, which has only got 40% battery, so we'll see how this goes. I've got, as you can imagine, an absolute ton of stuff to share with you. We're never going to get through it in one episode. You'll be bored to tears. So I'm just going to split it and I'm going to talk about some stuff now and some stuff in the next episode, which will only be about a week or so away. All the timestamps for all the sections are underneath this video. So if you want to jump to any particular section, you can. And we're going to do first giveaway news. There's two giveaways I'm going to draw the winners for in a moment. And then we are going to do finished objects, works in progress, and then the main bit of this podcast is going to be incoming stuff, which is all very yarn related, so you will enjoy it, I promise. I think that's all the introduction-y stuff. Thank you to everyone, by the way, who contacted me on Instagram and Ravelry and here on YouTube and by email to wish me a happy birthday. It was really, really lovely to just have so many lovely people. Oh, how many times can I say lovely in one sentence? But it was lovely to have so many people message me on my day, and it made me feel very, very special. So thank you very much. And thank you in particular to the podcast viewers who sent me some patterns via Ravelry, which I didn't even realise you could do. Thank you, Jan. Thank you, Beth, who I'll mention again in a moment. And thank you to Sam as well, who's Betsy Makes here on YouTube, and they all sent me patterns as a gift for my birthday, and I was so surprised by that and so touched, so thank you. Moving on to the giveaway, we've got two giveaways going on, and I've been very, very aware that I need to do this podcast because I want to draw the winners and I want to know who's going to get these lovely patterns. So we've got a giveaway for the Go Slow Hat by Barbara, who is knitting I love here on YouTube, and she's donated a lovely hat pattern, and I can't remember, I think we had about 16 or 17 entries to that, and I'm doing this the old-fashioned way. I've written them all down and I've put them in a bowl, so they're all in here. I can take that bit, that's to remind me, that's the Go Slow hat bowl. And then in my Hygge bowl I have all the winners of the winners, all the entrants for the Hygge shawl giveaway, which was a pattern donated by Lily of the Nordic Stitches podcast. But I'm going to put together a little Hygge parcel to go with that one as well. And I think there were about 30 odd entries into that one. So let's do the Go Slow hat first. So that's it. Let's do it. Which one is it? Oh, got two. Just not looking. And it is Rebecca, who is Raz Webster, and she was reply number 12 for the Go Slow hat. So well done, Rebecca. You have won the Go Slow hat, and I will pass your details on to Barbara, who will send the pattern to you. Yay! Hat pattern! Oh, and speaking of a lovely hat pattern and Barbara of Knitting I Love, I ordered from Barbara's online shop some of her little tags that she makes. These are little felt tags which you can attach to, let me take one out. You can attach them to your finished objects. So if you've got a hat, you can sew this on, and it kind of, I don't know, it adds a kind of professional touch. I've ordered them in green, pink, dark grey, and like a brown, and I they come in different little prints. So I've got the hearts, and I also got the let me just pop those down there. I also got the flower ones, which have got little flowers. Sorry if it's reflecting a little bit where they're in the packet, but they've got little flowers on them. And when they arrived, Barbara had very kindly put in a little set. So one's got hearts, one's got a cupcake, one's got a sheep, and one's got a flower. I'm not going to open them because I want to keep them in the packet, of these little tags to give away to one of you guys. So I'm actually going to hold on to those and put them into my giveaway that I'm planning, as I think someone suggested. I can't remember who it was. Someone suggested on YouTube or Instagram to call the giveaway the Celebrate Everything giveaway, because I'm currently almost at 1,000 subscribers on Instagram, which is amazing, and over 500 subscribers here on YouTube, and I'm 40. So it's the Celebrate Everything giveaway, which I'm sort of gathering things together for, but I'll talk more about that in the next episode. So yes, well done, Rebecca. And now on to the Hygge, we'll take the little tag out here, the Hygge shawl, excuse me, and parcel. So try and just get one this time. I don't know if you could see me doing that, or if you just saw like the edge of a bowl or something. Right, so the winner is Owls and Orchids, sorry, Owls and Orchids, and that is Sarah, and she was entry number 25. So well done, Sierra. I will contact you via Ravelry to get your address details so I can send your parcel to you, and Lily, who is Nordic Stitches, will send the pattern directly to you via Ravelry. So well done, Sierra, and well done, Rebecca. That's our two giveaways going. Now, speaking of the Hygge shawl, Lily is running a knit along for it, which starts on the 1st of May, so that's in about a week, just over a week's time. I'm going to be joining in with it. I'm going to be making, I was going to make the sport weight version, because you can do it in a sport weight or a fingering weight, but I'm finding it really, really hard to get a sport weight yarn. Sorry if I just flinched there. I just suddenly heard screaming from downstairs, but I think it's actually my husband chasing the girls around. So I hope that's what it is anyway, otherwise something dreadful is happening down there. What was I saying? Yes, I was going to do it in sport weight, but it's really hard to get like the colours that I wanted in sport weight. Oh, now he's got a message. Hang on a minute. Right, flick that. Right, it's gone. So I think I'm going to end up doing it in 4-ply fingering weight. And I'm going to order some yarn for that today because I've got some birthday money. And obviously, you know, I only got a ton of yarn for my birthday already, so I need to order more. So that starts on the 1st of May. Have I got anything else to say about that? No, that's it. So if you do fancy going along and joining in with the cow, yeah, it looks like a really nice pattern. I want to do mine in grey and white because they look like really cosy colours to me. Yeah, I'm really looking forward to getting stuck in with that one. So let's move on to finished objects. I have one finished object and these are my March mittens. So I'm just going to put them on so I can show them to you. These are my March mittens. So I'm joining in with the Basket of Mittens Cow, which is being hosted by Tiffany of the Woolen Homestead, who has a podcast here on YouTube, and Carrie, who is Granny Sheep on Ravelry, and my wool mitten on Instagram. It's a year-long cow, very much like the box of socks, but it's a basket of mittens. So I've done my January mittens, and February mittens were a sort of long-standing work in progress, which I was hoping to complete, but I wasn't loving it. So I've actually frogged those, and I'm going to start again completely with a new pattern. So I've got to do those. My March mittens are these ones. So these are my, these are the Cable Magic mittens. And they are by Naomi, who is Cozy Cute Knits on Ravelry and Instagram. And they're a really cute pattern. They've got the cable kind of runs off centre right next to the thumb. And I've made these from Seardar Snuggly. I had some Seardar Snuggly in grey or silver left over. Yeah, so I really, really like these. They're really, really comfy, warm and soft. And I made them because I can't remember what happened. I didn't have the right needle size. I couldn't quite get the right gauge. So instead of knitting a small size, I knit medium because I've got really small wrists and hands. And that's fitting me perfectly. So I'm actually going to use the same needles. I knit them on the Knit Pro Symphony needles, the wooden ones. I'm going to use the same needles and do a small size to make some for my two girls who have already tried to steal these ones. And they're not having them because these ones are mine. So, but I do have some pink and some sort of baby blue Seardar Snuggly, as well as some of this grey left. Because this used a really small amount of yarn. I think it just didn't even use 40 grams, I don't think. It was a really small amount and they were really quick to knit and very good fun. And Naomi was really helpful as well on a couple of points when I got stuck. So thank you, Naomi. So that's my one finished object. I have got several works in progress and I'm not going to go through them all because they haven't altered that much since I last spoke to you when I was in Cornwall. But I do want to just show you how my second springtime sock is coming along. So this is a sock, these are a pair of socks rather, that I'm knitting from yarn that I dyed myself, and this is the first and only time I've ever tried dyeing yarn, and I did it with Kool-Aid. So right, oh my goodness, that looks so different on the camera. I think Dan's camera is a bit better than mine. It's picking up colours. So see that pooling there? Doesn't look like that in real life. It's not that vibrant. It's a bit less so. Wonder what it looks like on this. Yeah, it's the same on this side. There's that massive green splodge. It's not like that in real life. This is my finished sock. Yeah. It's telling me it's got low battery. I knew that would happen. That's my finished sock. So you can see actually there's very little pooling of colour. It's quite an even spread. And it does look like on this second sock, I'm not quite getting that, not that it bothers me, because it was still fun. I'm not quite getting that even spread, I'm not sure why. But anyway, I made a bit of progress on that. I'm almost at the point to start the gusset increases. I think I'm about 10 rows away. And these are my travelling about socks. So if I go anywhere, these are the ones that come with me because they fit so nicely. I know I've mentioned this before, but they fit so nicely in my little handbag, knitting bag. So those are the ones that get thrown into my, into my backpack and things when I'm out and about. So that is one of my work in progress. And then my next work in progress, which is living in my tropical bag, because this was the best size for it. This is one that I made. I do make little project bags for myself. I don't consider myself to be a very good sewer whatsoever, but I can make project bags as long as you don't look at them too closely. Don't need to see the faults. So living in here is my Hotel of Bees shawl. So I was thinking about doing this and I was sort of umming and ahhing and looking at yarn and, oh, should I do it? I don't know. And then lovely Beth, who I mentioned at the start of this episode, sent me the Hotel of Bees pattern. She bought it for me on Ravelry. And there it was. It popped up in my library. A gift. Thank you, Beth. And, well, that was a sign then, wasn't it? So I went and got my yarn and started on the, can't remember the day it started, was it the 14th of April? Made a start and got immediately absolutely like drawn into it, and I've been really enjoying this, and it just feels to me, because I've been focusing a lot recently on knitting and knitting shawls. I've knit a lot of shawls recently, but crochet is my first love, and it feels so nice to have my crochet mojo back, because you know, I know what I'm doing with crochet. I know what I'm doing with knitting to a certain extent, but I'm always questioning it because I'm so new to it. I've only been knitting for a year and a bit. Sorry if I keep coughing. But with crochet, I just feel a lot more capable. So this is my Hotel of Bees shawl. Now, again, the colour is not going to come out completely true. It's coming out a lot more vibrant than it is in real life. Actually, it's not too bad. But where you can see the really, really, really vibrant pops of sort of reddy pink, it is a nice vibrant reddy pink, but it's not as prominent as it's showing on the screen. So if I hold it in front of the dark parts of me, you can see the, or maybe if I hold it up there. Don't know what the best way to do it is, because I'm trying to show you the honeycomb pattern. There you go. That I'm on there. So I've come through the there's a wing section, which is there, and then you go into an open honeycomb section, and then you go into the little bees section where you do your little bees. Can you see the bees? And then the honeycomb section. And now I'm just on to this second wing section where you have pink over grey instead of grey over pink. And the reason I've chosen these colours is because there was a weekend where I was really thinking about what colours to use. And I couldn't think of it. I just wasn't sure. Should I order some? Should I use something I've already got? And I was in the garden with the girls and we have this crab apple tree, which was in full blossom, and it starts with this really bright pink blossom and the blossom then turns white, and the bark of that tree is a very silvery bark. And at the time the blossom was pink, and I actually put a picture of it on Instagram, and I had some yarn in my very small stash that was gifted to me by an online friend around Christmas time. And it was absolutely gorgeous. It's by Kate Celine and it's called Peppermint Candy, and that's the pink. And the grey I had, it's Drops Flora, and I just had a couple of balls of it because I had ordered it because I was curious to see what it was like. And I like the grey and the pink together. And it just reminded me so much, the pink especially, just reminded me of that blossom, that pink and cream white blossom, which the bees were going mad for. And the grey just went really well, and also I felt was a good representation of the colour of the bark. I still don't know, there's a third colour in this shawl as you get towards the end. I don't know what it's going to be. I had some really good suggestions of like an apple green. I don't have anything in here that I can sort of demonstrate, but an apple green colour. But I still haven't decided. I've still got time. What the third colour is going to be. But this pattern is brilliant. It is so well written. You know, it's almost impossible to get it wrong because she helps you so much throughout the pattern. It's so detailed. And every time you start to get bored of one section, like I'm not a big lover of fillet, I think, crochet. Not a big fan of it. I have to concentrate too much. But as soon as you start getting bored with one particular section, you're on to the next section. And because it starts off wider at the bottom and gets narrower, because it's like a triangular shape, every row gets shorter. So, yeah, it's quite good. I think I might be quite a lazy crochet, a lazy person, really. I like it when things get easier. I like a challenge, but I like to know it's going to get easier towards the end, not harder. So, yeah, that's all living in my tropical bag, and that's going really, really well. And in fact, it's going so well, that's why I don't have much progress to show you on my other things, because my time's been absorbed with that. Sorry. Okay, so let's move on to, I just look at my little page of notes. I've made a page of notes because now that I'm 40, I'm very organised and grown up, so I have notes. Right, incoming. Now this is going to be the largest section, and that's why I'm going to split it over a couple of episodes. It's going to be a mix of yarn that I got, knitting and crochet related books that I got, other crafty yarny things that I got, and just other stuff to share with you. Like, for example, I got this necklace for my sister. Not going to come out at all, is it? Sorry. His phone's not as good as mine. Anyway, it's a little silver necklace, and it is from Rock Rose on Etsy, I believe. And it's a little silver rose. It's really pretty. So thank you, Jenny. Oh yes, she turned up. My sister turned up yesterday when she came for my meal with this massive hamper. It was this basket. Let's see if I can lift this up. With this basket, and she had made me a sort of knitting crochet hamper. She did it herself, and it was just stuffed full of things. In fact, yeah, let's start with some of the stuff that she gave me. So this is the yarn that she bought me. She bought me 4 skeins of hand dyed yarn, which I'd had listed in my favourites. I have had this in my favourites for so long, and then now that I've seen it in person, it's even better. Can't quite believe it. It's by Knit Cosmic Strings, or Cosmic Strings? Cosmic Strings. This is them. I think you will have heard of them. I think they exhibited at Edinburgh. I think they're based in Edinburgh. They are, it says on the back. I'm looking right at it. Contemporary Hand Dyed Yarn, Edinburgh. Cosmic Strings. And the colourway is Wabi Sabi, and this is a single ply superwash merino, and it is a 4-ply weight. Yeah, Wabi Sabi. Now this is coming out. That is that vibrant. It is that neon. It is that bright. I think it's getting a bit of glare from the light above me, isn't it? How amazing is this yarn? I'm doing that thing where you make the... I don't know why. Do excuse me, I had a lot of Prosecco last night. I'm wearing a lot of concealer as well. Oh, but this is just so lovely. So that is... I don't know what that's going to be. I think it's just going to have to be a piece of art for a while. Just going to have to admire it. So thank you, Jenny, for that one. And she also bought me, this is another one that I've had in my favourites for ages. And this came with such a lovely little gift as well. This is called Deep Sea, and it is by Black Elephant on Etsy, and it is a 75/25 superwash merino and nylon. And I love the colours on this. It is really glaring. Hang on, I'm going to try and bring this blind down. Hold on. I don't know if that's made the blind bit of difference or if it's like plunged me into darkness. But let's try again. This is the colour. Oh, it's a bit less glary, isn't it? And this is called Deep Sea. That's their tag there. And it came with this, look. This gorgeous little wooden crochet hook, a little 6mm wooden crochet hook, which is never going to focus. Maybe if I get out. I'm ridiculous, I'm sorry. Yeah, so how gorgeous is that? Not only that it came with it, but that my sister managed to resist and not steal it because she crochets too. I said, you could have kept that and I would never have known that she was such a good sister that she gave it to me. So thank you, Jenny, for that ultimate sacrifice. And she didn't stop there with the yarn. No. Right, I don't know. Both of these are really, really vibrant colourways and I'm not sure which one to go with first. Just knock my basket over. Actually, I didn't knock it over. It's the weight of stuff that's in there. Right, let's start with this one. This is called Firefly by Rhapsodye Yarns. These are going to be socks. These are going to be absolutely fantastically wonderful, wacky neon socks. It's got quite heavy chunks of black with a really neon sort of highlighter yellowy green. And it is 100% superwash merino. Machine wash on delicate cycle. So they're going to be precious socks. Socks that I will wash in a precious way. I'm very sorry. Clearly the effects of last night are beginning to catch up with me. This was the fourth bit of yarn that she bought me, the fourth skein of yarn that she bought me. And I have been eyeing this up for so long and I was really, really hoping that she had bought this for me, and she had. It is 75/25 superwash merino nylon in the colourway Hot Pink Hot Pants, and it is by the very lovely Sam of Betsy Makes, who is relatively, well, I don't know if she's new to dyeing, but I don't think she's been selling her hand dyed yarn for very long. And this is even prettier than it looked on the pictures on Etsy, because it's got, I don't know if I can get it to come up, but it's got all this kind of deep orangey colours and sort of dark speckles. And I love orange and pink. And I don't know if I just wasn't looking closely, but I didn't even realise just how much orange was in it. And it just makes it so much better. It makes it even better. Do you know when something arrives and you think it's going to be nice and it's even better? So I'm so pleased with that. And I actually don't know what this is going to be. It's sock yarn. It would make excellent socks. But then I do get a little bit like with my precious yarns, where they're hand dyed, I do sometimes think, oh, do I want to really, I don't know, hide them away? Do I? Not sure. So that's all the yarn my sister bought me. But she didn't stop there. No. She got me other things. But I think I am going to save them for next time. Yes, I will. Actually, no, I'll share with you one thing that she did get me. Because this is really funny. She got me this. So I'll show it to you in the order that I opened it. So I've got this bag of orangey gold and cream yarn with, what is it? It's like fishing line. It's fishing line. So I opened that and thought, okay, thanks for the random coloured yarn and fishing line. What's going on there? And then I open this. Animal heads. Trophy heads to crochet, and she's written inside it, "Dear Ali, at last, vegetarians can hang animal heads on their walls like the rest of civilization. Happy birthday." So, and then there's a note further in. The plot thickens. "We want this one. We're going to hang it over the bunny's cage as a warning." So my sister keeps guinea pigs and rabbits, and they live in the life of luxury in a shed, and in the daytime they come out into their run, their cage. And this is going to serve as a warning to all foxes who might wander by. This is going to be the warning for foxes. There's going to be a trophy fox head, crocheted one, of course, on the wall. But this is such a funny book. It's so hilarious. I mean, I have seen the animal trophy heads, like the unicorn one and stuff, at the yarn festivals. But this is so funny. Look. Lion and a bear. Slightly creepy as well. But my favourite one is the mice. Look, you can have teeny tiny little mice, and it looks like it might actually be an incredibly quick pattern to do. And you can have little mouse heads on your wall. So cute. Yeah, it only uses a tiny amount, just to use up remnants. It says this tiny fellow takes only a fraction of a ball, and it's a great way to use up remnants from other projects. So yeah, I think I might have a go at a mouse. Well, after, obviously, because she's bought me all the stuff to make the fox. So fox first, then mice. Okay, so everything else that she got me, I'm going to save for another time, because I wanted to show you a couple of other things that I got. So first of all, some project bags. My husband, Dan, amongst many other things that he got me this little project bag, which has got Matryoshka, Russian dolls. And it's got this gorgeous little floral fabric, and it's just really sweet. Just such a sweet little bag. And it's lined with the flowery fabric. And this was from Etsy. And it was from, and he chose this himself, Woolwick Crafts, I think it is. I can't quite read that. Is that just Woolwick Crafts? There they are. Yeah, so I've got, that's a perfect little sort of sock-sized or mitten-sized project bag. Really, really like that. I like the little project bags like that, the little ones. So yeah, really pleased with that. And then I have been coveting this. This is by a company, if memory serves me correctly, this is by a company that does print, it's a British company that does screen printed fabrics, called Thornback and Peel. And I'd seen this, someone had tagged me in it, in Instagram, I think, or on Facebook or somewhere, saying, "Oh, you'd love these bags." And I thought, yes, I would. If you've watched the podcast before, you will know that I absolutely love lobsters. So how could I not? I mean, this, for the size of this bag and for what it is, it wasn't cheap. But that's what I asked for, and that's what my mother-in-law got me. Lovely, lovely, lovely lobster bag. But that's not all she got me, because as well as vouchers and other bits and bobs, and oh, and I've got some little wool washy stuff, which I'm, that's a grapefruit flavour, and other bits and bobs. She also bought me this 100 gram scheme of natural 4-ply, this mini of natural 4-ply, this mini of natural Worcestershire 4-ply, which have all been sort of living in my little lobster bag, and two yarn dyeing kits, because she knew that I wanted to give it a go. These are from Devon Sun Yarns. They're both exactly the same, but the yarn weight is different. So I got one, I asked for something to help me get started becoming a go dyeing yarn. And I wanted 4-ply, so she got me a 4-ply one and a DK one as well. So they each come with 100 grams of the yarn, and then they come with all bits and bobs, pipettes and syringes and brushes and you know, gloves and instructions. And then there's citric acid and three food safe dyes. So it's blue, yellow and red. So yeah, and they come with basic instructions. But on the recommendation, when I first did a bit of yarn dyeing on this podcast, Sam, who's Betsy Makes, who I mentioned earlier, recommended a book. So I put that on my wish list for my birthday as well. And that was Knit One, Dye One, Knit One by Helen Day and Linda DeRuyter. I'll show it to you because I probably just mispronounced all of that. Yeah, so she got me this book as well, and I've already practically read it cover to cover. It's really, really good. It's very no nonsense and helpful. So I'm really looking forward to using some of these techniques, and it's demystified some of it a little bit for me. So yeah, I'm really, really looking forward to having a bash at that. So it's not going to be for a couple of weeks though, because I've got so much still going on for the next couple of weeks. My hours have changed at work. Yeah, so it's going to be a little while before I get to have another go at dyeing. But hopefully when I do, I'll do another little video of when I do that. So that's another thing that I got. Oh, this bag. Oh, yeah. You love it. And the yarn. Oh, the yarn. All my lovely presents, thank you very much. Don't know why I'm saying thank you. Actually, Jenny will be watching, my sister, but no one else. Right, what else could I show you? I probably rabbited on enough. I'm looking at more yarn to my right and more stuff to my left, but I think we're going to save that for next time. So, thank you very much for joining me. I think I'll just quickly show you one thing. My husband also... No, two things. No, one thing. Stop it. My husband got me a Socker's rule. Is that what it's called? Yeah, a Socker's rule, a dual scale rule with charts for measuring socks during knitting. And it's from Rosie's Moments. I'd seen these at the yarn shows and didn't get one. So he bought me one from her online shop. I still can't quite work out how it works. Or, sorry, it's just telling me again that it's running out of battery. I know you're running out of battery. I'm finishing. Yeah, not quite sure how it works, but I'm going to work it out. There is instructions, so I just need to make time to sit and read it properly. So I've got a little Socker's rule to help me make socks for people. So I was really pleased with that. And I've just realised I didn't show you with that, with my deep sea yarn from Black Elephant. This one. There was a couple of little freebies with it. It came right with a little bag of lavender and some buttons and things. But there was this really cute little stitch marker that I wanted to show you. Came with that cute little stitch marker. Really pretty. So I should have shown you that earlier. So yeah, she gave me that as well instead of keeping it. She did very well. So thank you very much for joining me. Congratulations to those who won the giveaways. And I think that's all for now. Thank you very much for taking this little portion of your day to join me to talk about the crafty stuff. And I will be back next week with a little bit more. Until then, take care and have lots of lovely knitty, crochet, crafty time. Bye.